Hey guys, welcome to Geardoms for What? Today we're going to find out how much weight this assortment of 3D printed gears will be able to lift up. Hint, it's going to be a metric f**k ton. But before I do that, I have to assemble this gearbox. Before I start assembling this, I'm just going to start getting some of this stuff out of the way that I don't need. And then I'm going to just start putting these gears together the way they go. So the way I put this together is I put marks on the sun gear, and then those marks go straight through the planet gears, and then they go right to the end of the ring. So if you line the number one up with the number one planet gear, with the line right through that, and then line that line up with the line on this ring gear, all the planet gears will be evenly spaced and they'll be in the right place. So I used a zip tie to hold this thing together while I was assembling it. That makes things really easy compared to the first time I tried it. So ring gear number one goes on first to align the gears, and then ring gear number two goes on, and just keep the numbers the same way, upright, and open up the gap in the ring, slide it on, and kind of give it a crank and it'll pop tight. Ring gear number three, same deal, keep the numbers the same way. So that's what all these marks should look like when this thing is aligned properly. Now I'm going to take these two rings and put them together and fill up the groove between them with ball bearings, and that's going to lock them together, and it's also going to support a lot of the weight on the output.
Okay, so once you get this whole outer section assembled, you can take the gearbox and make sure you line up the grooves inside here, and then make sure you line up the grooves on the outside of this gearbox. You can see this one's off a little bit right now, and I will straighten it. And then you take it, put it on the floor, and stomp on it. The gearbox slides right in. So that's how you assemble this thing. This orange gearbox and this orange part is a full spool of filament. This is all that was left from that spool of filament, so a lot of weight in plastic there. Anyways, since I got this all together, I think we can definitely lift more than this tiny scale can handle. So for today, I'm not going to be testing with the scale. I think I'm going to need something really heavy to try to lift up with this thing to get a real test on it. Hey Dylan, do we have an anvil?
You know, I think there might be one out in the shop.
Yeah, let's go out to the shop. Wrong way. That's pretty cool. Should we put a tire on top of it now?
String it through and redo this?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Connect to that.
Alright. How much weight do you think this is? 120 plus 70?
70, yeah, 190.
Yeah, so 190. I think it's safe to say that that worked. Okay, so we got two tires, 70 pounds each, and an anvil, 120, so 260, 260 pounds. It ain't gonna do this.
Use more back.
It could. Did that anvil sit down? No, it's on its side. I guess it. My tool broke. What do I do now?
If you would like to build one of these gearboxes yourself, there'll be a link to the Thingiverse files in the description. So, as it turns out, this gearbox beat my expectations for how much weight it can lift, and I'm definitely going to have to try lifting a lot more weight next time. If you have any questions or suggestions for me, leave a comment below. If you'd like to help my gear ratios reach a broader audience, then hit that like button and share this video with your friends. Hey, if you want to see more gearbox projects like this one, hit that subscribe button and hit that little bell to receive notifications for new uploads. Thanks for watching.